Welcome students, today's our topic is logical design of IoT. So logical design of IoT, Internet of Things, refers to an abstract representation of entities and processes without going into the low level specifics of the implementation. So for understanding the logical design, we are having the three headings, that is IoT functional blocks, IoT communication models, and IoT communication APIs. Now see one by one IoT functional block. So this diagram is for IoT functional block. IoT system comprising of number of functional block that provide the system the capabilities for identification, sensing, actuations, communication, and management. And these functional blocks are device, communication, services, management, security, and applications. Now see one by one. The devices. An IoT system comprised of devices that provide the sensing, actuation, monitoring, and control functions. The communication handles the communication for the IoT systems. Services for the device monitoring, device controlling services, and data publishing services, and services for the device discovery. Management block provides the various functions to govern the IoT systems. Security block, the IoT system secures and providing the functions such as authentication, authorization, message, and content integrity and data security. The application block is an interface that the user can use to control and monitor the various aspects of IoT system. So applications also allow users to view the system status and view to analyze the process data. Now the IoT communication models. In this IoT communication models, the first model is the request response communication model. So request response model, in this model, it is a communication model and in which the client sent request to the server and server respond to the request. So when the server receives a request, it decides how to respond, fetches the data, retrieves resources and representations, prepare the response, and then send to the response to the client. So request response is a stateless communication model and each request response pair is independent of others. So HTTP work as a request response protocol between the client and server, and a web browser may be the client and an application on the computer that hosts a websites that may be a server. For example, this client which sends the request to the server is a client, or browser submit an HTTP request to the server. Then the server returns a response to the client, and the response contains the status information about the request, and many may also be contain the requested content. So this is the request response communication model. Thank you. Thank you to all of you.